one of my viewer friends had asked about the correct method of wearing a face mask. And recently I have been seeing people on the street wearing face mask, entirely the wrong way. Let us see about correct method for wearing face mask today in this video. Hi friends, I am Dr. Karamat. This is Scientific Doctor Channel. In this channel, health related explanations are provided via videos every week. If you want to see such videos, subscribe to this channel. Also, press the bell icon adjacent to it to get instant notifications whenever new content is released. This week's video is about face masks and the method or the correct method for wearing and for disposal. We have to understand when we say face mask, there are different types of face masks. We can have cloth masks, we can have medical or surgical masks, or we can have respirators, commonly called as these N95 respirators. Why should we wear masks? Today, in this era of COVID-19, we know about the potential for infectious nature of pathogens. So, viruses and bacteria can spread from person to person, especially from an ill person to other normal persons via their respiratory secretions. The portal of entry of this respiratory secretions is through mouth and nose. So, in order to prevent this from happening, it is advised to wear face mask, especially in this kind of pandemics. Okay, so who should wear what? Essentially, the highest risk is for healthcare professionals who are dealing with patients who are already infected, or the persons who are taking care of sick persons. Third is for the sick person themselves, so that they don't spread the infection to others. So they have to wear proper mask. It should be either these so-called N95 respirators or medical or surgical masks. So other people can wear face mask made of cloth, because essentially this is just to prevent infection from happening when you are in public places. But if you are in a high risk situation, that is, if you are taking care of sick persons, or if you are going to a place where the chance of infection is more, like a crowded environment, it is preferable to wear a medical or surgical mask for any person, because cloth masks are just going to prevent the secretions from directly landing. These can't prevent viral or bacterial entry. This is just a first level of protection. Cloth mask may be just a simple cloth mask or something which is prepared. Essentially, the idea is these are reusable, but they have to be washed after every use. These are not perfectly protective against viruses or bacteria, but these can generally protect against your secretions from other persons directly coming into contact with your mouth and nose. So, in order for these to be effective, even if it is not so effective, they have to cover the nose and the mouth at all times. Masks of any type can be where you have strings to tie them, where you have ear loops, or where you have elastic bands like this. The principles of wearing a mask are similar for any type of mask. So, we have to initially wash your hands for at least 20 seconds, or if you can't wash your hands, use a sanitizer to clean the hands. Once your hands are clean, you have to take the mask. A clean mask which is not used before. For a medical or a surgical mask, there are two sides. There will be a dark colored side and there will be a light colored side. This light or white colored shade should be facing towards the person, and the dark, whether it is blue or green, should face away from the person. On the top side, there will be an aluminium strip embedded into it. For some mask, it might be some flexible plastic. This is the nose piece. So, this should be on the top. This should be the chin side or on the bottom. You cannot change it. So, the darker color side should face outward and the nose piece should be on the top. You have to hold the mask and you have to tie the top strings first over the ears and then you have to tie the bottom strings over your neck. Once this is done, this should be easily removable, so you can tie with a butterfly knot. So once this is done, you have to adjust the nose piece so that it snugly fits your face with both your hands. And you have to adjust the lower end to cover the mouth as well as the chin. Once this is done, you should not touch the mask again. Till the time you are wearing, this should be left as such. When you are removing, you can remove the lower piece first, the lower strings first, and the upper strings next. You have to remove the lower side first and the upper strings next. Why? So that the exposed portion is not coming into contact with your body or the clothes. You have to take the mask without touching the mask portion of it, just by holding the strings. Then by holding the strings, you have to dispose of it. I'll say about the disposal methods next. This method will also hold good for any type. If it is just having an ear loop, by just wearing the ear loop, you can fix it. Then fix your nose piece like to the face and draw the chin. While removing, just remove both these ear loops and hold via the loop. Once the mask is worn, you should not touch the inner portion or outer portion of the mask again. While you are removing also, you need to first sanitize your hands. Then with the help of the strings, you need to hold the mask, remove it. And if you are not in a high risk place, that is, there is no person who is sick, you are not taking care of a sick person, or you are not yourself the sick person. If you are the sick person, this has to be disposed of in the proper disposal method after disinfection with 1% hypochlorite solution, which can be prepared easily with bleaching powder. And then this has to be discarded in the correct corporation or the municipal waste management system. This is a hazardous waste. But if you are not exposed to any high risk individual, you are just using for yourself, this can be kept in a closed bin, then can be appropriately disposed of. Again, should not be put in the general waste. Consider this surgical mask. Surgical mask, when you compare to cloth mask, have three layers. One is an outer layer, which is usually darker in color, which is water repellent, so that any secretions which can come and fall are cordoned off. The inner portion is actually absorbent. That's why you should not change this. So lighter inner portion should be over the face, so that any secretions will get absorbed to the water absorbent area, and any secretions which are coming from outside are repelled off. The middle layer is the filter, which can filter the pathogens, that is the bacteria or the viruses. Because these surgical masks are not tight fitting entirely around the face, still there is possibility of air coming and going and infection also coming and going. So to avoid this, we need a much more better form called these respirators or N95 mask. These N95 means it filters 95% of particles below 3 microns in diameter. So those are the sizes of viruses and bacteria. So these are supposed to be more effective even than a surgical or a cloth mask. But remember, this is also 95%, nothing is 100%. So we have to take care of other precautions also in addition to wearing a mask. So for N95 mask or other masks which are having these looped structures, you have to hold like this, where you have washed your, sanitized your hands, you have to hold the mask, you have to keep it your nose and mouth, you have to draw the top string and the bottom string and adjust it accordingly. Then you have to fit your nose piece, adjust the chin piece. Once adjusted, they should never be touched. The mask portion should not touch. Why? Because when we are wearing this mask, it is implied that we are in a high risk environment. When you are in a high risk environment, there is potential for any pathogens, virus or bacteria, on top of it, sitting on top of it. So if you touch this while removing or doing anything, so you are at risk of infecting yourself as well as by touching other objects, spreading the infection. So while removing, we are not supposed to touch the mask itself. Anytime when you are removing the mask, you should not remove the top piece first. You should remove the bottom piece first so that this outer portion is not coming into contact with anything. You just hold it, then wear the top, remove the top piece like this and hold the mask with only the strings, and you have to dispose accordingly. So the basic etiquettes while wearing a mask is you should not touch the mask. The second etiquette is you can't remove and wear the mask again and again. So this is not permitted. Once you wear the mask, you are in a high risk environment. Till you come out of it, the mask should not be removed and reused. The surgical or medical masks are not reusable. They are one time use only. They can be used for a duration of 6 hours, maximum of 8 hours. If they are wet or soiled, they have to be changed immediately. You can't reuse them again, or you can't wash and use. So if you are not in a high risk environment, it is better to stick to cloth mask or face covers which can be washed every time. If you are using N95 in these crunch times, it is advised that you can use them again, but you have to keep those masks unused for 5 to 7 days so that you can use them again. You can do like this if it is not soiled or if it is not completely spoiled. You can use them again for 4 to 5 times, but you can't use a surgical or a medical mask, and every time you have to wash your cloth mask or face cover. Many a time nowadays these masks are available, but they are not actually 3-layered mask. Any surgical or medical mask, if it is intended to prevent infection, it should be 3-layered. There should be an outer water repellent layer, an inner absorbent layer and a middle filter which can filter the pathogens. If it is not like that, if it is a 2-ply or a single ply mask, that means it is similar to a cloth mask. Anyway, even if you are wearing mask, it is still important to adhere to the normal preventive measures, which are wash your hands, maintain social distancing at least for a distance of 6 feet between individuals, avoid crowded places, avoid unnecessarily going out of your home, and if possible, stay home to avoid infection with these pathogens. Common mistakes usually done by people, what I have noticed, is lowering the mask while wearing so that the nose is not covered. If your nose or mouth is not covered, it is not useful at all, even if it is a cloth mask. So when you are going out, the mask should always cover the nose as well as the mouth. The loops or the strings need not be crisscrossed so as to make it tight. Get an appropriate sized mask. Do not crisscross the ties or the loops. Do not reuse the single use mask, which are the surgical mask. Do not reuse, do not wash and use. So these are the things to be avoided while using a mask. Friends, hopefully this will be useful in these times while usage of mask. If you like this video, share it among your friends and relatives. If you want to see such videos, subscribe to this channel. Till we meet again, bye.